On the 9th of March 2014, I would have been here 44 years.
They're going to be sending the demolition contractors in, so the whole site will be flattened.
This is where it all started in the early 1900s. The railway was put in, the power station was built, and also a chimney. And then in the early 20s, Eastwoods took over.
In 1963, they extended the works because they put a new kiln in and they doubled the capacity of the works. So it was always known as the railway works, really from the 1900s till 2005, when unfortunately I had to close the railway system down. And over the years, we've taken a million tonne of material out, all coming out by rail.
Right, this was where the Romans were, settlement was found. Along the side here is a ditch, and that was the boundary. Just over the hill there, we found the Roman bodies. I come down here one day when they'd finished digging at this level, and I found a vertebrae, a large vertebrae and two teeth. Put the bits in a bucket, didn't really think a lot more about it, and then the Natural History Museum rung me up. When they see it, they said, "You have found the bones of an ichthyosaur."
The open days, which I helped to run for 20 years, were an opportunity for the railway enthusiasts to see the old steam locos running in a proper working environment. I thought it was great because they got so much enjoyment out, and that's what it's all about. They got enjoyment out of the railway, seeing the railway run. At that time, it was the only quarry in the United Kingdom running on the railway system. In 2011, number 4 kiln was partially demolished, ending nearly 100 years of cement production at Barrington. Being the state-of-the-art plant when built in 1963, but was obsolete, inefficient in comparison with the modern kilns. There's nothing much left here but rust, dust and pigeon droppings.
Yeah, this is the first time I've been up here for quite a few years, but it's just a sad sight to see everything now part demolished and just really in a bad state of repair that just waiting for what next.